This is how I'm able to read Twitch and YouTube chat on my streaming phone screen. It's also how I'm able to hear both chats on this chat app with text-to-speech. And I'm going to share with you how it works in today's video. Let's start with the main streaming phone and the apps I use. For Android, there's iWire Pro, and for iPhone, there's Mobile. Both have a chat system built into them and lots of other features I've covered on my channel, like H.265, SRT, stream recording, audio levels, connection bonding, and more. To read chat on your Android's phone screen, with iWire Pro, go into the settings, streamer, Twitch username, enter your Twitch username, and then OK. To read chat on your iPhone screen with Moblin, go into the settings, streams, the stream we set up in this other video, scroll down until you get to chat and viewers, and then Twitch. Enter your channel name and channel ID for channel emotes and number of viewers. And you can get your channel ID by Googling Twitch channel ID. For text-to-speech, there's this app for Android and iPhone called IRL Link. So this is what I would hear in my headset.
YouTube, F-E-A-R-L-E-S-S-H-Y-E-N-A says, say something.
Thank you. Jump into the settings, which you'll find on the bottom right. Text-to-speech, then enable text-to-speech with this toggle button. If you'd like to know more, I have a video covering all of its main features. The next step is to relay your YouTube messages into your Twitch chat, like in this example here. I think at least for now, this is the best way to read and hear YouTube messages, all thanks to Streamer.bot. If we switch over to the Streamer.bot instance we've been working on, you'll notice I've added a new action called Chat Relay YouTube. This action is triggered whenever someone in YouTube chat types a message. You'll find this trigger from the right-click menu as YouTube Chat and Message. In sub-actions, I've already added this code. You'll find this sub-action from the right-click menu as Core C-Sharp Execute C-Sharp Code. Let's have a look at the code. This first part retrieves the username of the person who typed in YouTube chat. But if there's a problem and their info can't be retrieved, the code will end here and won't continue any further. The second part checks the username against a list of usernames you want excluded from the relay chat. For example, you probably don't want your bot account's messages relaying info about changing scenes. This code also ends here and won't continue any further if there's a match. The third part is a check for the user's message and will end here too if there's a problem. And finally, this part of the code means there wasn't a problem with the username and message using the format of YouTube username says message. Here's what that looks like from a recent live stream. So in YouTube, I'm just going to say hi from YouTube. So in there, we've got my bot relaying a message from YouTube. It says cliffcreates says hi from YouTube. Anyway, compile the code to make sure everything's okay, then save and compile. Here's a couple of things to keep in mind. Check that you're logged into your broadcaster and bot accounts on YouTube by going to platforms along the top, YouTube and account. Private streams to YouTube don't have a chat, so make sure your broadcast is an unlisted or public stream to YouTube. Streamer.bot has a limited amount of quota for YouTube, which means the relay chat might stop working while you're in the middle of a live stream. For me, this usually happens in the afternoon, so knowing this, I open the YouTube app to check in on things. I've heard the Streamer.bot team are trying to work something out with YouTube, so hopefully that's all sorted by the time you watch this video. And that about covers it for today's video. For the next one, I'll be covering overlays like this one to display today's date. And a couple other things I do for my streams, so make sure you like and subscribe to be notified of that video. Also, a quick thank you to these awesome people for making this video possible. So that about covers like this one to display today's date.